up in that noonday, searching for the truth.
Not knowing who we are, got us groping at noonday. Working 9 to 5, got us groping at noonday. The food all devoured, got us groping at noonday.
Feed your spirit, turn your radio at noonday. The laws that shield and buckler get you ready for doomsday. Sat me in the midst of the valley, we smoke since foes like Cali. Another black man dead, so that's another tally. Don't get caught in the alley, cause they smoking hot pack. Them guns cop back, we teaching on the corners where they cop at. They try to kill our brothers, so with them scriptures we shot back. Purple and gold across the globe, you can't top that. Black man in unity, this verse is my eulogy. The kingdom for people who never had an opportunity. 12 gates for the 12 tribes, we rule the people that oppress us. Yeah, I know you feel the vibes, better choose a side. Don't wanna repent because the pride indoctrinated us. Our brother Esau, he really hated us. On the shores of Africa, the white man invaded us. Berlin conference, they raided us.
Black man, yeah, he is a black man, but do you have this white man's philosophies in your mind? That's what we're trying to bring out. So watch this, we're trying to cast these things out of you. Read that, Leviticus 11 and 2, speak
unto the children of Israel, saying, these are the beasts which you shall eat among all the beasts that are on the earth.
Right, so it says speak unto the children of Israel. To who? The blacks, Hispanics, and natives. So guess what, this people right here, they have a particular thing, a diet that we're supposed to eat. You know what I'm saying? All other nations, they eat whatever the hell they want to. But us as a people, God said, speak unto the children of Israel, and these are the beasts of the field which you shall eat. Read.
Whatever parted the hoof and is cloven footed.
So whatever parted the hoof, you know what I'm saying? They got a foot like this and it's cloven footed. Read.
And chew with the cud.
And do with what?
And chew with the cud.
And do with what? You listening? What's your name again?
Lonnie.
You listening? Pay attention. So he says, so whatever parteth the hoof and cheweth the cud. Read.
Among the beasts, that shall you eat.
So among the beasts, that shall you eat. So that's like you what? Your cow, the beef. Because what? It part the hoof. You know what I'm saying? It got a split foot. And it chewed the cud. I mean, it got a regurgitation system where it constantly brings up the food, chews it again, and processes it. Right. But does the pig, now the pig, because you eat pork, right? Does the pig do that? Does the pig chew the cud? No, watch this. Read on.
Leviticus 11 and 7.
Uh-huh.
And the swine.
And the what?
And the swine.
And the swine. What swine? Bacon, pig, pork. The white man's meat,
read. So he divides the hoof and be cloven footed.
So though he divides us, so the pig actually got a cloven foot. So he, the pig meets one of the criteria, but read.
Yet he cheweth not the cud.
Yeah, he don't chew the cud. He don't regurgitate his food. It doesn't process the food like God wants it to. Read.
He is unclean to you.
He is what?
He is unclean.
He is unclean unto you.
Right.
So you understand it. Because it said that we shouldn't eat these things. Because it said, since it's unclean, we can't eat it. Read the top part again.
And the swine, though he divide the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud. He is unclean.
Right, so now give me the fish. Now give me the fish, because that's other beasts that walk the land with. So you got your cow, you got your derby that you can eat. So you can eat those things. But when it comes to the pig, which is popular in America, because who made that popular? White man. Because I don't know if you ever seen Roots? The movie, the show Roots. When Kunta Kinte first came to America, and they put him in the slave, the plantation, all other slaves. One of the slaves that was helping him out to get home to be conditioned to being a slave, he brought him pork. And they first came to him, like, what is this? He's like, no, I don't want that. We don't eat that where I'm from.
That's right.
We didn't start eating these things until the white man forced them on us.
That's right.
Just like they forced their religion on us. You know what I'm saying? We learned that. We learned our diet here in America. You know what I'm saying? And that's why you got everybody in America what? Obese.
Come on.
Got heart problems.
Come on.
I'm saying going through all types of hot blood pressure.
Come on.
Gout, what's the stuff dealing with the stomach, gestational, I don't know how to say it, we all jacked up over it because why, we eating an evil diet, we eating the diet of what, this white man, which is what, most of our people's gods, because even though you don't subscribe to this image, you know what I'm saying, but you subscribe to his ways,
That's
so you gotta get these things out of you.
Right.
I say, come out of her and be separate from the ways of America. Be separate from the ways of sin. That's what we're trying to show you. Because the whole reason that we went into this condition right here is because of our sin. How you doing, brother? What's your name?
Herman.
All right, so check this out. We are teaching the Bible. We just showing our people that Christ is a black man according to the Bible, and that black people, that we are the real Jews according to the Bible.
Yes,
and with
right.
us being the Jews, us being the children of Israel, and I'm saying God gave us a dietary law. That's what we're going over right now. So give me the fish. Watch this. Because let me ask you a question. Do you eat pork, shrimp, crab, lobster? Do you eat catfish? Okay, so watch this. So we're going over the diet that God gave his people. Watch this.
Verse 9. These shall you eat of all that are in the waters.
All right, so these are the fish that you should eat of all that's in the waters. Read.
Whatsoever have fins and scales.
So whatsoever have what?
Fins and scales.
Whatsoever have what?
Fins and scales.
Fins and scales. Fins and scales. Does a catfish have scales?
No.
It got fins, but it don't got scales. So guess what? You ain't supposed to eat it. Because exactly, you can eat bass. That's good fish. That's clean in the eyes of God. You see what I'm saying? It's not bad for your body. It's good for you. I said God labeled what's good for you to eat and what's not good. It's just that simple. But us in our what? In our destruction, we learn these things. And then we hold true to them to this day. We hold this like it's a law. Like if you tell a black person you can't eat pork, that's blasphemy. You don't eat no bacon. You don't eat no pork. You don't like the baby back ribs, brother. Like, nah, bro, we can't do that. You see what I'm saying? But it's because it goes completely against the ways that we was educated. It goes against the ways of what? The gods that and the idols that we got set up in our hearts and our minds. Because it said what? It said it has to have fins and scales. So our people what? Eat catfish? Our people eat shrimp? You know what I'm saying? Lobster? Crab? These don't have fins and scales. So God said, these are the things that you should not eat. You know what I'm saying? But for eating these things, what? Not saying it brought our people to what? Slavery. Bondage. Because read on.
Whatsoever have fins and scales in the waters, in the seas, and in the rivers, them shall you eat. And all that have not fins and scales in the seas and in the rivers, of all that move in the waters, and of any living thing which is in the waters, they shall be an abomination unto you.
They shall be what?
An abomination unto you.
So the Lord said all these things are going to be what? An abomination unto you. So if you eating these things, what does that make you? Abomination. And the Lord hateth all abomination. And we don't want to be in the sight of God hated. But guess what? The ways that we live and the things that we do, it makes us hated in the sight of God. That's why we're like, damn, why are we going through so much hell? Why are we going through so much tribulation? You know what I'm saying? Because we're not doing the things which our Father instructed us to do. So he has to bring us punishments. Now let me ask you a question. Because, you know, everybody wants to get to heaven, right? Everybody wants to get to heaven. Okay. So can you get to heaven by eating these abominable things? Right, give me Isaiah 66, 17, and then give me a Revelation.
Bring it up.
Because watch this, check this out. Because you know, the Christian church, right? They teach that... If he said don't eat pork and you do it anyway, that's not love. Loving God goes into doing what he says. You know what I'm saying? So guess what? All the Ten Commandments still applies. Give me that real quick. Give me the love of God real quick. Give me the love of God.
Bring it out.
Watch this. This is what it means. It's simple. But you see what I'm saying? Like now you said that, right? That philosophy, that doctrine that you just came with, you learned that from him. And you didn't even know it. See, you were regurgitating things and you were doing things that you're not even consciously aware that came from him.
Because nowhere in the Bible does it say you don't got to keep the commandments no more. You know what I'm saying? It say you got two great, these are the two greatest commandments, but all the commandments fall under that. So watch this, 1 John 5 and 3. It's going to make it real simple. Watch this.
1 John chapter 5, verse 3. For this is the love of God.
For this is what?
The love of God.
So this is the love of God, the greatest commandment. It's the love of God, right?
That we keep his commandments.
That we do what?
That we keep his commandments.
So the love of God is that we keep his commandments.
That's right.
So that's how you love God and you love your neighbor as yourself. By applying the commandments of God. That's right. All it's talking about. It never said that you can, now you can eat pork. Now I can go just sleep around with any woman. Now I can go rob. Now I can go kill. No. Because you can't love God if you're doing those things.
Right.
But that's the hypocrisy that this white man taught us. These are the philosophies that he put in your brain, that he put in your spirit. But we heard God sent his prophets this day to pour these things out of you. So watch this. Now give me Isaiah, watch this. You know what I'm saying? Because these things that we got to hold true to. And you might think, damn, eating pork is just a small thing. The catfish, it's not that serious. You know what I'm saying? To my granny do it, my mama do it, my daddy do it, my cousin. Right. Exactly. Hey, you a smart man. That's right. But watch this. But our people don't got faith. They got faith in this white man. They don't got faith in God.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because God said, keep my commandments for thy good. They said, no, I'm going to do what the white man tell me for my good, for my benefit. And they follow all his ways. And they live in the hell. And then they'll say it's all good in the hood. Watch this.
Isaiah 66:17. They that sanctify themselves and purify themselves in the gardens behind one tree in the midst.
Uh-huh.
Eating swine's flesh.
Start at verse 15.
Verse 15. Uh-huh. For behold, the Lord will come with fire.
Hold on, the Lord gonna come with what?
With fire.
Nah, I thought he was coming with hugs and kisses, brother.
Uh-oh.
He said he coming back with fire.
Fire.
Why is God coming back with fire?
Read. And with his chariots like a whirlwind.
What is them chariots talking about? It's talking about them UFOs that they seeing out there. So why is the...
Those are fallen angels.
Right, hold on. They ain't fallen angels. They strong angels. And they come back to judge the world with God.
That's right.
So what? We got these chariots, right? And again, you're right. It is angels in them. It's angels in them UFOs. God is coming back with an army. He coming back with a fleet. So if he coming with a fleet, what does that mean he doing? So why he coming with legions of angels? Why?
You know?
He taking what? He taking his. He's going to take over the whole planet and deliver his people.
Right.
But now God going to give you stipulations on delivering his people.
Yeah.
Because he's going to read it.
It's going to explain itself.
Surrender his anger with fury.
Surrender what?
His anger with fury.
Because God has anger. God has fury that he has to bring upon this planet. Because God is mad at the enslavement of our people.
Right.
The atrocities that we went through. And I said that the cotton fields, the tobacco fields, the plantation, being raped, being made to work up sun up from sundown. And I said the murdering of our babies, us being shot down in the streets.
Bring it up.
Us being redlined in America.
Bring it up.
You know what I'm saying? Them framing laws by mission. The civil rights era. The Jim Crow laws.
Right.
The black codes.
Right.
And I said all the evils that we go through all over the planet Earth. God sees all of that.
Yeah.
And it made him angry.
Right.
So guess what? It's vengeance that he has to bring upon this earth to appease his anger. Because that anger ain't going to go away until what? Blood is shed.
Right.
And that's gospel. That's the Bible. But they say in the Christian church, God coming to give hugs and kisses.
You know, and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh.
So with fire and with this sword, the Lord gonna plead with all flesh. He gonna judge the earth. He bringing fire and sword. That sound like what?
Yeah.
Death and destruction.
War.
That's battle, war. I just said battle, war.
Read. And the slain of the Lord shall be many.
Hold on. Wait. Nah. But that ain't the Bible. Read it again. Is that the Bible?
And the slain of the Lord shall be many.
He said the slain of the Lord shall be many. Now, Sean, he don't believe that. That's King James. King James. Okay, said the slain of the Lord shall be what?
Shall be many.
Shall be many. So the Lord is coming to bring great judgment upon the earth. So watch this now. Now we're going to get to the point. Here we go.
They that sanctify themselves.
So when the Lord comes up with his judgments, it says they that sanctify themselves, read,
and purify themselves in the gardens behind one tree in the midst, eating swine's flesh.
Eating what?
Swine's flesh.
Eating swine's flesh. Read.
And the abomination.
And the what?
And the abomination. And the mouth.
And the mouth, because you know Negroes down south, they be eating possums. I don't know if they do it in Kansas City. Are you from the south? So you know we be eating possums. Yeah, from Tennessee. You ever had possum soup?
Raccoon.
You know what I'm saying? No. Okay, nah. It's people that do it. Hey, that's me. That's who do it. You said what? Turtle, rabbit.
Yeah, you
eat rabbit. Dirt is clean. That's clean.
That's
right. Not saying, but that turtle, but that rabbit, that possum. Nah, that's enough. Raccoon, squirrel meat. You ever had some squirrel meat before? See, that's what our people do. So the Lord said the people that's doing those things, watch this.
Shall be consumed together.
Shall be what?
Shall be consumed.
Shall be consumed together. You know what consumed means? Because it said he coming with fire. You know what fire does to your flesh? It's gonna consume it. It's gonna melt your melt your flesh off your bones. Brimstone, right? Fire and brimstone. That's going into thermonuclear fire. That's the judgment for eating pork.
Bring it out.
That's the judgment for eating shrimp.
Bring it out.
That's the judgment for eating rabbit.
Bring it out.
Bring it out.
That's crazy, ain't it? You see, God don't play. God said, you're going to eat what I tell you to eat, or you will be part of my slain.
That's right.
Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models.
And fire!